Hi guys, it's Taff. Welcome back to Euro Truck Simulator 2 with the Go East expansion. Here we are, is our beautiful majestic truck just spinning around on the screen in front of us. We currently got 75,721 euros in the bank, but we need another job. Basically what I've done, I've just off screen, I have basically rested because we needed some rest. So I have done that. And so let's go to the freight market. And I was having a look because we're at Vienna, or Vienna, of course. Apologies. Let's start off straight off the hat with the apologies for my completely oblivious to the fact that, you know, we were driving to Vienna, the capital of Austria. Yes, I do apologise if I offended anyone with that. It's not for of course I know where Austria is and Vienna. I think it was more a case of an early morning before work, pre-coffee, mind derp. So yeah, apologize for that, but let's skip on quite quickly. Head held down in shame. I was having a look at this one. This is the best money per distance at 38.16 euros per mile. Offer expires in 2 hours 7 minutes. It's 11 grand in total. Oh, we do, there's 13 grand here, but that's going a bit further. So I think this is probably the best one into Slovakia. So we're going to Kosice? I think that's how you pronounce it. Apologies again if I've ruined that. We're going to take 13 tons of ice cream, which is pretty cool. I've actually driven to the depot already. Let's just okay, sorting out my lights and everything. So which, oh, one thing I haven't done is actually selected the job. So it is that one. Take job. Yes. Okay, so it's this trailer just in front of us. Perfect. Oh, my wheels weren't straight. Okay. Right. Let's turn that annoying beep off and let's go forward. Okay, we're away. Right, let's try and get out of Vienna. So we need to hang on. Just trying to think. We're driving on the right, aren't we? Yes, we are. Of course we are. Oh, blimey. Yeah, there you go. Okay, so ooh. Sorry, it went quiet then as I was just concentrating, not trying to hit that iron barrier. I'm a bit all over the road, actually. I'm struggling to keep control of this. Oh, we're doing okay. Right, so we're doing 30 now, which is fine. Coming up to the red light. Hey, green, go. So here we are, back on Euro Truck. Doing quite well actually. Had a quick look at the company's daily profit, which stands at about 10 grand a day. Now, 10 grand a day is fine. That's basically just deducting the truck costs, fuel, wear, you know, that kind of thing, and driving wages for Georgia. And obviously we've got a, I can't remember how much our loan, I think our loan payments were about 3 or 4 grand, weren't they? Was it three? I think it was 3,000 euros a day, so we're still making about seven, oh, we're going to go in a turn here. We're still making about 7,000 or 6,500 euros profit a day, which ain't bad. I'm sure you'll agree. I'd quite like to make 8 grand, or sorry, 7 grand a day. That'd be very nice. I'm sure most of you would too. So that's doing quite well. So we're in a profit, which is nice. We've got, as I say, 77. Oh, Georgia must have just kicked in, because we've now got 77,480. Sorry, and 78 euros. So she's brought in a bit of cash there, which is great. we've got a right coming up here. I might just, hang on, when we get to a straight bit, I might just reset my track IR. Hang on. Stand by. There we go. That's better. Yeah, that's much better. I see what I'm doing there. Oh, we got a tractor and combine. Lovely. Oh, talking of tractors and combines. Yes, so the final, the season finale for historical farming was has been done and sent out. It's not the finest video I've ever produced. I'll openly admit that. There's all sorts of technical issues from the video point of view, but I put it out anyway because A, it marks the end of that series and the end of me playing that Let's Play, which is quite momentous, really. Yeah, some of the bugs in that game. Oh my God, that it didn't let us go quietly, did it? It went out with a bang, which is always it's always how it should be. Not quite what I was expecting, to be honest, but it was a little bit crazy. But there we go, so that will be retired now. I shall be playing no more historical farming. I don't think we could have gone much further on it anyway, to be honest with you. It's very limited what you can actually do in the game. But Agricultural Simulator will keep going, because that's good fun. And yeah, we're making some... Whoa, hang on. Just coming up to the border. The border? The border? That went all a bit slippery on the road there. Well, I was going probably too fast is the honest reason why that was happening. So yeah, I will continue doing Agricultural Simulator. Maybe trying to get 2 episodes out a week, hopefully. Or at least one every 7 or 8 days. Which is obviously just about a week. And I think I'm going a little bit too fast. Let's just slow down a bit. Slow down a touch, because I'm rushing this. And there's no need to rush. Okay, coming up to Bratislava. I'm sorry, I'm looking at that. How is this? Okay. It's really foggy this morning. I'm just trying to figure out how the road works. Okay, whoa, stop. Yeah, I was trying to work out if that was a bridge or... I can't see anything. I'm going to creep out slowly. Oh God. Oh, there's a car. Okay. This is really difficult to see. I think we're good. Whoops. Oh, just got around that sign. There's nothing coming, so let's move over to here. Not the best bit of driving you'll ever see, but we're through. And we're on our way. Yeah, so... historical farming. That will be retired now, and we'll do a bit more ag sim, see how far we can go in that game as well. But I'm really enjoying that at the moment. It's got some good things coming through on that, and hopefully there'll be a patch coming out soon, because I've been doing a lot of work in the beta testing, and it would be nice to see a release patch anytime soon, you know, just to help us all out. Whether or not that will mean the save game will be corrupted or whatever happened last time when we had to start again. Oh my God, this fog is absolutely thick. Let's see, so it's like a real pea super, this is. Okay, is Bratislava on the whoa, I've got a bit of a wiggle on then. Oh my God, this is really difficult. I can't see anything. Speeding offence, brilliant! I was doing 35 miles an hour and I got a speeding offence. Oh, fantastic, thank you, Bratislavian police. Okay, there's a car in front. Okay, this must be 30 here, because I'm doing 32 and I'm blasting past all these guys. No, 80. Okay, I think you're going to pull over now, so let me just merge back into this lane. 110, yeah, we're going uphill. Going over some sort of bridge, I think. Oh, there's the silhouette of a town over there, which I can't... Yeah, hopefully this fog's actually lifting a little bit. Oh, look, they've got some sort of crane, or is it a, I don't know what that is. Yeah, crane, I think. Ah. That's crazy. So, yeah, so we'll still go strong on... I keep interrupting myself, don't I? For Agricultural Simulator, that's cool. B17's going well. We're only a few missions now from completing the tour. Whether or not we'll get there is... well, we'll have to wait and see, but we're going really well at the moment, and it'll be horrible to lose it at this late stage. But so that's going to be coming to an end one way or the other quite soon. So that's quite interesting, because we'll have a bit more time. Obviously, I will do another series of that. Obviously, we talked about Squadron Commander mode, and we'll have some mods on there. But I may take a couple of weeks break from it, just so you know I can tidy things up and get ready and have a play with all the mods I was looking at to see which ones I want to do. But that will come across quite quickly. Oh, there's a crash there. Lost the middle barrier. We're actually turning off here. This is probably a silly thing to do, try and overtake. Yeah, it's a really silly thing to do. We're never going to do it. We're never going to do it. Let's... Whoa, we got close to him. Wow. This is not the best driving in the world, is it? Oh, goodness me. So B17's come to an end. We'll obviously, there will be a series 2. But once I have a little play with the mods, they may have a week or two off from that. What else do we do? War Thunder. I was online last night with Joseph, William and Thomas. We had a good laugh, actually. Although it was slightly interrupted by a client update, which meant we had to restart, and then we couldn't get on. Whoa. Car come in. Looks clear. Okay. Right. So we'll be doing a few more War Thunders. I've got a couple of videos recorded last night. I haven't looked through them fully and to check the audio to see if they'll come out on the video, but at least one of them will, because there's some good footage in there. We took all the bombers out, which was good fun. I managed to upgrade my Wellington to have a £4,000 bomb, and I did a bit of damage. I didn't do that much damage, actually, but it looked impressive anyway. So I'll try and get that footage up next week, which should be cool. So a lot more to come from War Thunder. They've also released some tech tree information for the tank side of that game, which looks quite interesting. So I'll be having a look at that as well. Hopefully there won't be too long before we get the land battles coming through. And also, I have been looking at Cliffs of Dover. Cliffs of Dover! Now, it's getting very exciting. Very exciting. Because they are just about to release the next patch. I think it's version 4. Oh, look! There's a van. Whoa! They're about to release version 4 of the Team Fusion patch. And I think... So it's Sunday morning now. And I think... sometime during the week, I think they said Wednesday, they're going to release the readme of all the tweaks and improvement and bug fixes they've done. And if it goes through, it's in final packaging now, and if it all goes deploys fine with the beta testers and there's no major bugs, then it should be rolled out end of next week, I believe, which is super exciting, which will mean I'll be on probably the ATAG server a lot at the I'm away next weekend, actually, but the following week I should be on there having loads of fun. I was just wondering if we should have got some fuel there. No, we got a third of a tank, we should be fine. So yes, I know they've been doing a lot of work with new models like ships and stuff, and they're doing a load of particle work and some tweaks here and there, and to stop the clouds popping, and to stop planes disappearing, so they've been working on the visual loading of planes and aircraft in your sort of visual sphere, which, oh, if they've nailed that down, because that's one of my biggest problems, is spotting aircraft. But ah, it looks immense. I can't wait to read what they've done, and then yeah, I'll get some videos out as soon as possible on that. I've also been doing a lot of, well, actually for the last week and a half, amazingly, I haven't touched Grand Theft Auto 5. So after the first week of absolutely loving it and playing it to death, I must admit I haven't touched it since, which is a bit strange. Life and other things have got in the way, so hopefully I'll try and find some time to do a bit more of that, because I've been having a bit of fun on that. I must start to do some of the actual main missions, but I've just been, you know, being me, I've just been sort of messing around in the world. Oh, wow, I didn't get a speeding ticket. And having a bit of fun, and I've found some really nice things. So hopefully I've got enough footage. I've probably got about, I don't know, 2 hours footage recorded in little segments, which I want to compile together to have a little another little look at some of my favourite bits and pieces. I could right go past this car, this truck, really, couldn't I? I'm just sitting behind him. Right, let's. I've lost my momentum though. That's the problem. Yep. So I will be playing Grand Theft. We'll be playing a bit of Grand Theft Auto. What I have got going is, I've got a 3-day week next week at work, which is cool. I can't wait. So I've got Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, which just happen to be the 3 worst days of my week at work anyway. They're the ones of all the meetings and all the... basically, I'll go and grovel in front of people to say, yeah, really sorry. Won't happen again because of things that have gone wrong in the company, which I really don't enjoy. But no, I don't really. It's Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday tends to be reviews to see how things went over the weekend, and then you have your weekly reviews on Tuesday and Wednesdays, and then you have a review on a Friday to make sure everything's in place for the weekend, you know, those kind of things. So I'm avoiding that one, but that's not the trouble one. We're going to make a write up here shortly, so we're not going to get past this truck. Actually, we got 3.5 hours. I might just check the map. I might just fill up here, actually. Yeah, I think I might just fill up here. So, yes, I am... Okay, we're going downhill. Let's slow down. Whoa, 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 whoa. Wow, he took that quick, that tanker. Okay, nothing coming. Brilliant. So I've got 3-day week next week, which is cool. I'm off Thursday, Friday, and the following week. Now, I'm away that weekend, so I'm going away Friday morning for 4 or 5 days. And I should be back probably Tuesday or Wednesday the following week. And the good thing is, I then got a few days to, I can just sort of sit around. Obviously, get the washing and stuff done once you unpack the suitcase and your bags and stuff. But, okay, E. It's €1.35 a litre. Okay. How much are we going to cost us? Wow. €581 to fill up. Wow. Okay, so €1.35 is not bad, actually. Whoa, this red car going. It's about £1.40 in the UK at the moment. Well, £1.40 a litre for diesel. Let's go. There's a car and a truck. Oh, okay, he's brave. That's fine. We've got a clear run now. After this truck. Cool. Yeah, so it's 140.9, round about that in the UK. So, yeah. 135 seems about right. It's a bit cheap, actually. Well, compared to it is in Britain. which should be interesting. That's actually interesting. Depending on where you are in the world, let me know how much a litre of fuel is, a litre of diesel, because I would really be interested to see, because we seem to think we pay a lot of fuel duty and tax on our petrol. So the government, I think, take a huge percentage of our of the cost of fuel in tax. So it would be really interesting to know how other places around Europe and America and all the other areas that people watch this video. Let me know how much a litre of diesel is. Yeah, if you don't know, next time you're out, have a look at the garage and let us know, because I just like to get a little poll going to see how much fuel is around the world. And obviously let me know what your location. Whoa, I should be stopping there. Who's got right of way? I don't know, I'll go anyway. Yeah, so put your location and how much a litre of diesel costs. Just for my own interest. Oh my god, look at that. It's been a huge crash there. Is there? What's going on there? Has that van had a crash? There's a guy just appeared and he's... Okay. Oh, I think the people appeared because it stopped raining. So the people only come out when it's... Okay, that's fine. Have you noticed there's loads of skid marks on the road? Is that some sort of statement about Eastern European drivers? You know, I'm not making that statement. I'm asking the question. Look, there's another one. Look. Do you have more crashes in Eastern Europe? I don't know. Well, you've seen my driving. It's not the best. Whoa. Wow. It's 8:18 in the morning. We can probably turn the lights off. Okay, we're going well. We've only got we've got just under 3 hours to go, which is good. Anyway, so yeah, let me know what the fuel prices are in your area and where you are, which would be really interesting for me, because I'm quite sad like that. So next time I'm complaining about fuel, like I say, oh, well, in X or such and such an area, it's this much, you know. Just because that's how dull I am sometimes. But yeah, no, that'll be really interested in that. So if you wouldn't mind, just let us know. That'd be great. Stick them in the comments. That'd be perfectamundo. What was I talking about before that? I don't know. If I'm tired, I am tired, because I played... getting overtaken. I was playing more Thunder last night with the guys, and I'm kind of glad the client update wasn't, because that was the first time I checked the time, and after that, when I couldn't get back on, it'd gone 1 a.m. and I thought, meh, I'll go to bed. I'm tired. I had to be up early this morning anyway, so... Yeah, it was probably a small mercy, actually, for me. Otherwise, I'll be just a wreck today. Notice I'm really leaning in towards the screen. I should really lean out. You get a better angle and viewpoint, actually, if I lean back a little bit. Ah, but here we are. Here we're going. What was I talking about? Oh, my time off, wasn't I? Yes, I was... Yes, I've got that week off, so I'll be able to catch up big time. And I may... Oh, God, hang on. I'm struggling up this hill. Depending on how things are going... lovely lake there. Oops. I may look to do... may start another Let's Play on something. Or I'll do a couple of showcases, anyway. I want to... get a bit of Grand Theft Auto footage up again, and I want to do bits and pieces. Obviously, a lot of Cliffs of Dover, probably, if that patch comes out. Ooh. Sorry, I was just looking at my something. My mouse started flashing crazy. Look, there's another crash gone on over the edge there. Yes. Whoa, 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 whoa. Slow down, ease, and was taking it gently. At least the weather's improved, so the grip should improve, I should think. So yeah, I'll be playing loads of games the end of next week once I've done all the, you know, the usual chores of emptying the bag, you know, you take your away bag, getting settled back in and getting everything on the move. I should be doing a lot more videoing and potentially showcasing a couple more games. I've got millions of them, absolute millions of them. Steam sale is actually you know, I'd be a rich man. Well, I wouldn't be, but I'd be a richer man if it wasn't for Steam. Because they just kick out these little Steam sales. What's going on over there? Have you seen that? Oh, hang on, let's just slow down a bit. Because I can't drive and look at the same time. All those whole red and white. Oh, no. They look like lighthouses from the other direction, but they're not, clearly. No. It's a stupid thing to say. Okay, we've got some tractors in there. Got some plows. That's looking cool. Come on. Struggling. I was just watching the... There we go. I was wondering when it was going to pop a gear. So yeah, we're going quite well in all other videos. The Morrowind one, I've had to give up on it. On one of the episodes anyway. So I might do a couple more Morrowind, but they will be... there'll be a bit of a chunk in the middle, because for whatever reason, it won't record... Oh, well, it's... Sorry. The one I recorded, I've produced a video, and... It just doesn't want to play on YouTube. YouTube doesn't like it. Look at this combine, it's actually moving. That's pretty cool. Is that new? That's pretty cool, isn't it? Is this tractor moving as well? No, he's sitting there having a pickle sandwich and a cup of tea. Don't blame him, he's probably worked hard. So yeah, for whatever reason, I don't know. It plays fine on my PC. I've tried to re-render it, I've tried to cut bits off, I've tried to do all sorts, you know, convert it into a different file, and it, for whatever reason, YouTube will just not play it, so I don't know. I don't know on that one, so it may just be a big chunk, and I might pick up from where I left off. As I say, that's a kind of a secondary one, so it's not going to deter from the likes of this, Agricultural Simulator B17, and... War Thunder, Cliffs of Dover, those ones, which seem to be my main ones. Obviously, I've got Dark Messiah going as well, which I'm really enjoying. But again, that's more of a secondary one as well. I was starting to pair them up. You know, when you get secondary, I don't know. You know, I don't know if you know what I mean when I say secondary one. Obviously, my main Let's Plays are this now. B17 is obviously the main one with Agricultural Simulator. They tend to be the big sort of the billboard ones, as you were, and I've got a couple more running in the background. So yeah, I'm really enjoying Dark Messiah. That's actually quite good, but I don't think, you know, that's not going to last that many episodes, because it's not that long a game, and we are crawling up this hill. Oh my god, 19 miles an hour. But yeah, I've been talking to some of you via mail and via comments about what other things we can do. Obviously, a suggestion was to come in to do a bit of Silent Hunter, the old submarine simulator, which I do love. Look, another skid mark so on the road. Somebody's come around that far too quick, and has looked like they've jackknifed onto our side, or they've... Yeah, because you wouldn't... I don't know how they've done that. Oh, wow. 15 miles an hour. So yeah, I might have a little play with... I might install Silent Hunter. Silent Hunter 3, I think, because that was my favourite of all of them. 3 is when you're in the Atlantic, as in the U-boat, taking down, obviously, Allied shipping. And then you've got 4, which is in the Pacific. And so you can be US or... I'm guessing you... I don't know. I know you can be US, because I played it as a US, but it's been such a long time, I can't remember if you can select any other nations on that. And then there's... Silent Hunter 5, speed camera, as long as we're doing 14 we should be fine. And then there's 5, which is, I think it's back into the Kriegsmarine as the Germans, but I didn't get on with that one for some reason. It just felt a bit arcadey. Not that I'm saying I'm, you know, well, let me put this straight, I'm not the best sub skipper in the world at all. I am very lazy, I don't fully understand everything, and you know, I use a lot of the aids, like the aiming aids and stuff like that, and navigation aids, because I'm not the best, and you know, I want to play it to enjoy it rather than to be an expert in navigation. So yeah, I might do some of that. Oh, that's another crash. Oh no, it's a park. Oh, that's parking. Oh my god, I'm not going off there. I'll never get back on. So yeah, I may do some. I may do a showcase on Silent Hunter 3 and see what people think. And if they want to see more, then I may well do a. Oh my god, we're going quick. We may well do a let's play if it gets a reasonable response. Oh my god, we're like an out of control. We're going 50 here. Slow down. Break. We're going far too quick down there. God, that could be exciting. Oh, this is just gaining speed all the way down this hill. I'm not even accelerating. That's just pure gravity pulling us along at 10 miles an hour again. Look, we're absolutely flying. 52, 53, 54, 5, 6. I haven't touched the accelerator since the top of the hill. Wow, that's quite impressive. So yeah, I'll get some of that. I've also got well, I played it ages ago on the Xbox, but I've also got Sniper Elite 2 or V2. Oh, I just love that game. Just the, you know, like the CSI ballistics as the as you take a shot against the unwary soldiers. It's absolutely awesome. So I may do a showcase on that as well, and if you want to, I might do a playthrough on that, because that's a good game and I love it, and it's all good. Okay, we're coming into the town now. Oh yeah, also I've been having a chat with Frank on the email, and some suggestions, and I'm glad he found these videos on Steam, and he managed to find me on YouTube, which is, I'm really pleased you're on board and you're enjoying the vids. So great stuff there, and a couple of good suggestions as well. So I might do some. One of the suggestions was we can do some research. Me. I should do some research and not be so lazy, and explain a little bit about the towns we're delivering to, which I must admit I've forgotten to do up till now. But yeah, so I'll probably start that in the future, because we're just coming into it now and we've got 3 minutes, so it's a little bit pointless. Traffic jam. Boom. What's over there? Anything? So we're coming to Kosice, I think that's how you pronounce it. Now, I believe actually this is the capital of culture, twinned with Marseille. Or it's not twinned with Marseille, but Marseille is also the joint capital of culture this year, or at the moment. I don't know how often it rotates around cities, but. Yep, some building work going on there. Well. The vehicles are there. I can't actually see anyone doing anything. We've got some pedestrians. No, typical building. Look, there's no one there. No one there. Right, I'm wondering, let's just have a quick look at the sat nav. I might go all the way around. Where the light? Oh, lights are red anyway. But we got a question mark up the front. So I'll we'll go straight on, and we'll just do a little loop around the town, because we've got plenty of time. I think we've got we've got just under 4 hours to get this job loaded. So oh, I can't see the lights. There we are. So yeah, just as we're coming in. One last thing about the channel. Obviously. I didn't talk about 7 Days to Die, which I am loving. I absolutely love. What I need to do is actually get it. The problem is, if I record that one episode, then leave it, and come back in a week or two and record another episode, it's really, I struggle to keep a scope of what's going on all the time. So it kind of starts. I lose a lot of time with my mind just trying to remember what I was planning to do. So I'm going to do 3 or 4 episodes recorded in a row, and obviously I'll feed them out and schedule them for every week or so, and hopefully that will give a little bit more flow to them, which would be good. what we've got here. We've got a recruitment agency. Okay, that's not exciting, but... Ah, well. And we got a repair yard to our right somewhere. Big garage repair yard type thing. Over there. Oh, and I really wanted to stay in this lane because we're going around. Okay, perfect. Oh, so here we are. Another day and another job. All success. Well, so far, so good. It's going well. And fingers crossed, this should be easy money. Right, we just got to try and find the yard now, is it? No, that's like a supermarket or something. Cell plan, that's it. That was the place. So we'll go back in the back. Oh, look, traffic's been very kind to us. Okay, we got a bump here. No, we don't. Yes, we do. Take it gently over the bump. Wow, this is bright. Can I see where the... I'll have one go at this if I balls this up. Oh, I think I balls it up already. Tongue out, maximum concentration. No, this is going horribly wrong. We're parking alongside. Oh, that's awful. That is absolutely awful. I can't do that. That's just pure embarrassment and professional pride. I can't leave the trailer like that. It's quite a Oh, we're gonna jackknife if we're not careful. Okay, very quietly, very slowly. Bulls this up even worse than I had. Right, fine, let's just park it. Oh no, that's the radio. You didn't want to press I wanted to press E. Oh, press enter, that's it, boom. Oh my goodness. That was awful. Job completed, excellent. Ice cream delivered, yay, ice cream. Distance driven 280 miles. It took us 8 hours 33 minutes and it consumed 223.3 litres of diesel. Let me know how much that costs in your area. Lovely, thank you. Base rewards, we got 9,687 euros and 452 XP. Proficiency bonus of level 5 got netted us 726 euros. And a long distance delivery bonus at rank 2 netted us 908 euros and 113 XP. We haven't leveled up. We moved up the level 5 of Enthusiast and we should tip over level 6 next time, which is pretty cool. There you go, 87 grand in the bank. 87666, wow. We're doing quite well. Let's just have a quick look at our company as a whole. So we've made 67 grand profit in the last 7 days, which is pretty good. Daily profit of 11 grand. Now, I don't believe that takes into consideration our loan. So let's have a look at the company. That's this. Because we haven't done a week yet. The productivity is not really displaying at the moment, but it's fine. So we're doing 45%. Oh no, last week. Okay, so that's last week. So current productivity is 45%. So we're doing okay. We're not fully equipped garage of this size. Expected to earn this much. Okay, so but we're a truck down. So we're only at 2/3 capacity anyway. And we're doing almost 45%. So we need to step that up a little bit to get that around the 65% mark. But we're doing okay. You know, Georgia's needs to level up a bit. And so do we. So I think we're doing okay. So that's 76,000 minus the truck maintenance, the fuel costs, and the driver's pay. And so, yes, we do have to take the loan out of that one as well, which isn't too bad. Drivers, how are we doing? So we're doing okay. 1.7, and we earn about 25.95 a mile as a base, which isn't too bad. Let's have a quick look at Georgia. And she's currently coming from Rotterdam, and she's going back to Transinet in Cambridge, which is great. So she's working, she's on the job, so to speak. So that's going quite well. So we're not a million miles away from being able to afford another truck. So what I'll probably do is wait till we get to about 120,000, get another truck and get another driver, and then we may put a couple of mods, or not mods, a couple of updates on our truck, just to jazz it up a bit. Maybe a paint scheme or some accessories, maybe, you know, bull bar and some extra auxiliary lights, which would be nice. But we'll have a look at that and play with that next time. So here we are. We've made another delivery. We've got 87,666, all the sixes, well, three of the sixes in our in the bank, and things are going great. And Georgia's earning some good money as well. We're doing more than enough to pay off our loan, which was, oh, it's $6,000 a day. Wow, ouch. Wow, that's expensive. So we're making about $4,000 or $5,000 a day, which isn't bad. And we've got 2% damage on the truck, which should be our tires, no doubt. So there we go. So here we are. We are all done and dusted for today. I hope you've enjoyed this episode. I'll stop rambling now because I realized I have sort of got myself into a rambling loop. And I'll say thank you for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this. If you have, then please like and comment and let me know the fuel prices in your area, because I'm sad and I enjoy that kind of stuff. And join me next time when we'll be going somewhere else. Where should we go, actually? We could probably look next time. So we've come pretty much as far east as we can. So we'll probably go up north, maybe. Does that sound good? Maybe go north? Or do you want to come into Hungary? I don't know. We'll have a look, see what options are open to us next time. So I've been Taff from Exile. Thanks for watching, and join me next time.